Graduates and guests, today graduation ceremony is about to begin. Swinburne University of Technology Chancellor Mr. Graham Goldsmith will preside over the ceremony. The academic procession is about to enter the hall. Would you please stand?
Please remain standing for the national anthem. The words are printed inside the back cover of the ceremony program and will also be displayed on the screen. Please be seated. My name is Janet Hiller, Dean, Health Sciences. I'd like to welcome you all to this graduation ceremony. This is one of three ceremonies the university is holding today for more than 800 Swinburne graduates. It is now my pleasure to introduce the people who are seated on stage. Seated at the centre of the stage is Mr. Graham Goldsmith, Chancellor, who will preside over this ceremony. The Chancellor is joined today by Professor Linda Christensen, Vice-Chancellor and President of Swinburne University of Technology. Mr. Brian Sadgrove being awarded an honorary doctorate at today's ceremony. Ms. Pauline Farrell, Director, Educational Leadership and Student Experience. Professor Scott Thompson-Whiteside, Executive Dean, Faculty of Health, Arts and Design. And Professor Bernadine Van Gramberg, Pro Vice Chancellor, Graduate Research and Research Training. The other staff seated on stage are academics and professional staff who have played such a large part in the success of today's graduates. It now gives me great pleasure to invite Mr. Graham Goldsmith, Chancellor, Swinburne University of Technology, to formally open proceedings.
Vice-Chancellor, members of the University Council, members of staff, distinguished guests, graduates, families and friends. On behalf of Swinburne University of Technology, it is my pleasure to welcome you to this graduation ceremony today. As a mark of respect to Australia's Indigenous people, Swinburne University of Technology respectfully acknowledges the Wurundjeri and Boonwurrung people of the Kulin Nation as the traditional custodians of the land where we now meet to conduct this important ceremony. I would also like to pay my respects to elders past and present of the Kulin Nation and extend that respect to all Indigenous people present today. Today's ceremony acknowledges the academic and research achievements of our students and represents a significant step in their lifelong learning journey. We're very pleased that so many parents, families and friends have been able to attend, with, I'm aware, many of you travelling to Melbourne from countries around the world for this special occasion. On the occasion of this ceremony, the Council and staff of the University wish to offer their congratulations to graduates on the achievement of their qualifications. For all of us, this ceremony is a significant milestone. For you, our graduates, it acknowledges the culmination of years of study, hard work, and achievement. For the parents, families, and friends of the graduates, it is an important public recognition of all the sacrifices that you have made and all the support that you have provided to our graduates. Today is an opportunity to celebrate this shared achievement. You, like we, will feel a great sense of pride and happiness in seeing your friend or family member succeed in this most significant way. For the academic and professional staff of the university, there is enormous satisfaction in seeing our students successfully complete their studies. And whilst this ceremony rightly celebrates the achievements of our students, it is also an important occasion for the university. Swinburne prides itself on the quality of its teaching and learning and the excellence of its research. This ceremony gives public recognition of Swinburne's commitment to provide our students with a range of high-quality educational qualifications. These qualifications will assist them to make an ongoing contribution to their chosen profession or vocation, and importantly, to their particular community. We are committed to being both a nationally and an internationally recognised university in the fields of science, technology, design, business, and innovation. Our education programs and our research are relevant to the world community as well as to Australia. We have a significant commitment to international education and take pride in seeing our graduates from around the world find meaningful careers. Our researchers routinely collaborate with scholars from around the world, and through such collaborations, we have a greater social impact. Today, you, our graduates, join an international community of professionals who will make a difference. Thank you for the privilege of allowing us to teach you and for enriching our community with your quest for knowledge. I think that Michael Bloomberg, the former mayor of New York, put it well when he noted that some of the most useful knowledge that you leave your university with is about how to study, how to cooperate, how to listen carefully, how to think critically, and how to resolve conflicts through reason. These are some of the most important skills that you will need in the working world. Now it gives me pleasure to call upon Professor Linda Christensen, Vice-Chancellor and President of Swinburne University, to introduce the next part of the proceedings.
Chancellor, I call upon Mr. Brian Sadgrove to present himself for admission to the degree of Doctor of Design, honoris causa, in recognition of his significant contributions to the Australian graphic design industry. Brian Sadgrove has been a key contributor to the formation and direction of the Australian graphic design industry over a 50-year career, beginning in the 1960s. Since the establishment of Sadgrove Design in 1968, Brian has created some of the most enduring visual identities in Australian corporate and design history. Logos designed by him for Channel 9, Quit, Heart Foundation, and the Yarra Valley Water are still in use today. Other major clients and projects include Australia Post, more than 20 stamp designs, including the 1972 Olympic Games series, were Brian's work, the $50 banknote, Melbourne Film Festival, the National Gallery of Victoria, the Royal Botanic Gardens of Melbourne, Victoria Police, Cabrini Hospital, Pacific Dunlop, and the former Ansett and Compass Airlines and State Bank of Victoria. Early in his career, Brian established the cover design standards for independent publisher Sun Books, producing a body of work over a 7-year period that set a high watermark for publishing design in Australia. The markers of Brian's work, modernist clarity and simplicity, inflected with humanistic and visually dynamic elements, contributed significantly to the dissemination of the international aesthetic in graphic design throughout the Australian design industry. His use of sans serif typefaces and consideration of form and space within a composition modelled how graphic designers could give a distinctive professional face to Australian businesses and non-commercial organisations. Brian, who is a member of the Design Institute of Australia Hall of Fame and the Australian Graphic Design Association Hall of Fame, has had a very close connection with the Visual Communication Design Program at Swinburne. Throughout the 1990s, he was a member of the Course Advisory Committee and was an important contributor to course development. He recognized the complex nature of the process of educating design students to make the transition to highly competent and successful designers after graduation. Brian knew that Swinburne consistently produced Australia's best design graduates and was extremely gratified to have contributed to this process. He continues his involvement as an external examiner for student portfolios and has provided much sage advice to Swinburne graduates after their graduation. Brian's significant contribution to the university and the Australian graphic design industry is most aptly recognized through this honorary doctorate. Chancellor, it is with great pleasure that, in accordance with Swinburne University of Technology legislation, I present to you Mr. Brian Sadgrove for admission to the degree of Doctor of Design, honoris causa. Chancellor, it's with pleasure that I invite Dr. Brian Sadgrove to say a few words on this special occasion.
Thank you, Vice-Chancellor, Chancellor, members of Council, and academic staff. I am indeed honoured. And my congratulations to all the Swinburne graduates here this evening. I am fully aware of the amount of work that you have put into your studies to take you to this place. I owe great debt to the late Ian McNeilage, the former Dean of the Faculty of Art, who retired in 1987. In 1959, his first year with Swinburne, he showed me that I didn't really have to be an accountant, for which I am forever grateful. Thank you, Ian. I thank my clients, most of them at least, who generate the projects, and I thank my colleagues who, with patience, help me to provide answers. Design can be defined as meaningful intervention. So now, as graduates, you can do just that, which is a very good thing. Honour the work was my high school motto. Enjoy the work seems to me to be equally valid. Design work, by its very nature, is enjoyable. So in that way, it's really not work. And that way you can keep doing it for a lifetime, believe me. Be nice, be happy, it'll show in your work. And again, thank you, Swinburne.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sadgrove, for your insightful comments and our hearty congratulations again on today's recognition of your inspiring achievements. Unfortunately, when I started at Swinburne, no one showed me that I shouldn't be an accountant. Can I ask all our graduates to please stand? By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Council of Swinburne University of Technology, I hereby admit you as graduates to the awards for which you have qualified and to all the rights and privileges of those awards. Congratulations to you all. Please be seated. I now call upon Ms. Pauline Farrell, Director, Educational Leadership and Student Experience, to present the Vocational Education and Pathways graduates.
I have great pleasure in presenting to you our Pathways and Vocational Education graduates. Today we recognise their hard work, their dedication and the talent of our graduates. You are to be congratulated on your achievements. Take pride in your graduation and we wish you great success in your chosen field and we hope to see you again at Swinburne throughout your lifelong learning journey. Chancellor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates on whom the awards have been conferred. For the Certificate IV in Accounting, Paraskevi Ahilarus. For the Certificate IV in Bookkeeping, Michelle Ryan. For the Diploma of Accounting, Annie Lou Roxas. For the Diploma of Business, Nikita Jesse Hall. For the Diploma of Community Services, Nina Yuan. For the Diploma of Early Childhood Education and Care, Hiroko Asano. Chika Sorosa. Shirley Tay. For the Diploma of Engineering, Unilink, Bradley Eric Johnson. For the Diploma of Human Resource Management, Caitlin May Mari Doyle. For the Diploma of Information Technology, Unilink, Halud Salih Hidayb Al Hamahi. For the Diploma of Interior Design and Decoration, Rupa Shari Rao. Catherine Fanny Villabos. For the Diploma of Library and Information Services, Elizabeth Irene Heckelberg. Jody Poole. Priscilla Segura Vences. For the Diploma of Marketing, Brooke Mortimer. For the Diploma of Musical Theatre, Brooke Kotzes. For the Diploma of Nursing, Enrolled Division 2 Nursing, Rachel Olivia Bott. Jane Louise Richardson. Mary Zoros. For the Diploma of Project Management, Sohal Hussain. For the Diploma of Screen and Media, Francis Lawrence Kennedy Couples. For the Advanced Diploma of Engineering Technology, Peter David Sawera. Pooja Todd. For the Advanced Diploma of Screen and Media, Nathan Ainsley Andrew Rhodes. For the Graduate Certificate in Applied Business, Coaching and Mentoring, Carla Josephine Grist. For the Graduate Certificate in Organisational Coaching, Jordan Louise Bryan. Chancellor, that concludes the awards for the Pathways in Vocational Education. Thank you.
Chancellor, today I have the privilege and pleasure of presenting the graduates from the Faculty of Health, Arts and Design. Swinburne takes pride in providing educational opportunities that enable our students to acquire the knowledge and skills necessary to function effectively in their chosen field of work. The faculty's courses are examined and revised on a regular basis to ensure you, our graduates, not only have the required knowledge and skills, but more importantly, have the ability and confidence to use them in a work situation. You should be confident that you are well prepared to pursue your career aspirations. We're living in an ever-changing, complex world that presents numerous opportunities and challenges for you as graduates. Embrace the challenges and opportunities you encounter, knowing that you are well prepared to act on them. By doing so, you will contribute to making Australia, or wherever you choose to live, a better place. The faculty, our academics and professional staff offer our sincere and heartiest congratulations to all of our graduates on this very special day. Enjoy the experience of the day. Acknowledge what you have accomplished during your time at Swinburne and share this very important achievement with your family and friends who have helped you along the way. Chancellor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates on whom an award has been conferred. For the Bachelor of Arts, Stuart Bladin. Joanne Louise Hajar. Rachel Leanne Miko Odi. For the Bachelor of Arts, Digital Media, Sashiko Jaime Robinson. Nadaraja Sanyavan. For the Bachelor of Arts, Digital Media and Marketing, Benjamin James Angus. Chi Ying Lau. Justin Daniel Tyler. For the Bachelor of Arts, Games and Interactivity and Bachelor of Science, Computer Science and Software Engineering, Brendan Lee Keesing. For the Bachelor of Arts, Journalism, Benjamin James Cotton. John Brendan Donohoe. Alexandra Sonia Fayum. Michael John Hookey. Georgia Catherine Manning. Anthony Charles Pinder. Derek Richard Schlensteck. For the Bachelor of Arts, Literature, Jacob Colin Edward Miller. For the Bachelor of Arts, Media and Communication, John Leonard Nicholas Anderson. Joe E. Chai. Vasucha Hongyok. For the Bachelor of Arts, Politics and Public Policy, Meredith Claire Foster. For the Bachelor of Arts, Professional Writing and Editing, Gaia Marie Gusta. Columbia Winterton. For the Bachelor of Arts, Psychology, Taylor Diamud Gogan. Erin Keeley Hughes. Alexandra Marie Nixon. William Preston Charles Younger. For the Bachelor of Arts, Psychology and Forensic Science, Meg Elizabeth Brandenburg. Nicholas James Nicola. James Alexander Panoutsos. For the Bachelor of Arts, Psychology and Sports Science, Eliza Michelle Ogg. Margot Elizabeth Thompson. For the Bachelor of Arts, Security and Counterterrorism, Rachel Baran. For the Bachelor of Behavioural Studies, Jessica K. Coxall. Katrina Marie Knoll. For the Bachelor of Behavioural Studies, Psychology, Nikki Alexopoulos. Rebecca Jennifer Rachel Andrews. Hannah Marie Brown. Benjamin Francis Burke. Jessica Cartwright. Ying Ying Zit Chan. Ryan Davies. Nikki Evans. Genevieve Margaret Everett. Mark Rosewell Fernandez. Sandra Giles. Patricia Alinta Catherine Guzman Moreno. Janine Healy Maldrum. Gemma Lee Longbottom. Ashley Machuca. Angie Natalie Marsden. Anne Malberg Chelecki. Cameron Moss. Yvonne Muller. Jamie Lee Reese. Simon Rutherford. Louisa Sparks. Kelly Stead. Yadranka Stupa. Kathy Tulloch. Claire Catherine Vickers. Shane Walker. Adam Wood. Tanya Elizabeth Yarrington. For the Bachelor of Communication, Lachlan Robert Bennett. Cindy V. Nguyen. For the Bachelor of Communication, Advertising, Ellen Maureen Duffy. Carl Robert Kaldawi. Michael Ariel Saunders. For the Bachelor of Communication Media Studies, Tracy Bui. Nicole Cook. Megan Croucher. Morgan Ian Dunn. Sonia Gargo. Mandy Giannopoulos. Lisa Margaret Marchant. Jack Michael. Shannon Wapet. For the Bachelor of Communication, Public Relations, Louise Callio. Timothy Patrick Carroll. Isabella Ann Harris Hookway. Jackson Jones. Grayson Ann Jones. Iveta Kochinova. Tatiana Mendoza. Kitikul Musa. Joanne Nemšić. Dongshan Tan Nguyen. Kate Veronique Potter. Marissa Silveri. Emily Claire Tracy. Hannah Young. For the Bachelor of Communications, Public Relations, Julia Rachel Krellin. Megan Leslie. For the Bachelor of Design, Stephanie Deborah Aromatris. For the Bachelor of Design, Communication Design, Jessica Lee Chiarilli. Earl Brian Cortez. Anine Esterhausen. Caitlin Grace Hall. Virginia Marie Hester. Nguyen Thai Vu Le. Jenny Leo. Lick Man Lo. Jia Chen Lu. Anthony Joseph Lupino. Samuel David Marsepust. Sadie Rose Slorak. Azam Taufik. And Jani Alyssa Ulita. Shou Hui Wang. For the Bachelor of Design, Communication Design and Bachelor of Business, Alicia Hannah Celia. Georgia Bethwyn Irvin. Christina Met Wilson. For the Bachelor of Design, Digital Media Design, Michelle Joanna Bassett. Lloyd Raymond Richards. Jack Samuel Snowden. Christopher Warner. Christine Nikki Yiannopoulos. For the Bachelor of Design, Digital Media Design and Bachelor of Business, Albert Benjamin Brunda. Shelby Jane Healy. Brandon James Saliba. For the Bachelor of Design, Industrial Design, Wei Ho Leung. For the Bachelor of Design, Interior Design and Bachelor of Business, Jasmine Zoe Mosedale. Fiona Louise Pearson. For the Bachelor of Education, Primary, Heath Bradley Callahan. Jacqueline Lee Dye. Tracy Kearney. Nicole Loxton. Timothy James Lumsden. Jacqueline Rogerson. Christine Kylie Taylor. For the Bachelor of Education, Early Childhood, Elusola Olanike Bolinawa. Helena Byrne. Stephanie Marie Dickinson. Mandeep Kaur. Amy McDonald. Janelle Marie Seen. Skye Simpkins. Liesel von der Borg. Melissa Jane Widdock. For the Bachelor of Film and Television, Amy Francis Booth. Isaac Dennis Bowen. Lauren Claire Kathleen Brewerin. Yi Wu Chen. Brendan James Cherry. Drew William Collins. Thomas Brian Cotter. Logan Davies. Jessica Dixon. Gabrielle Renee Fisher. Joshua Don Galbraith. Carla Rafaela Giolio. Jason Michael Hooker. Ella Jean Humphreys. Sarah Jane Levy. Shannon Kelly Malak. Ruth Bethany Mossbauer. Riley Thomas Muscat. Vanessa Amber Orslowski. Tegan Elizabeth Rogers. Robert Bernard Wilkes Rogers. Zara Page Senstock. Timothy Peter Smith. Sam Han Ilvan Munan. Cassandra Jane Vincent. For the Bachelor of Health Science, Lauren Marie Alberico. Janae Leanne Kalaje. Jessica Laura Clover. Mark Alistair Greenwood. Emily Louise Hislop. Daniel Stefan Hoffman. Jessica Alice May Hutton. Sabrin Halif. Crystal Michelle Lorraine Murphy. Feng Dung Nguyen. Freshta Kasimi. Kieran Tyler Roberts. Carmen Rose Smith. Monique Yvonne Van Vissen. For the Bachelor of Media and Communication, Liana Olivia Gardi. For For the Bachelor of Multimedia, Games and Interactivity and Bachelor of Science, Computer Science and Software Engineering, Benjamin Joseph Hayes. For the Bachelor of Professional Communication, Danielle Josephine Azzolini. For the Bachelor of Science, Biomedical Science, Simane Abseye. Zara Ali. Chantal Maria de Cruz. Huda Urjaz. Lucin Nosta. Ilhan Omar. Boris Edward Peters. Halida Kalanda. For the Bachelor of Science, Psychology, Rata Kuropa Kompong. Emma Kate Story. For the Bachelor of Science, Psychology and Psychophysiology, Julia Brodsky. Viola Putri Pramadi. Sophie Elizabeth Stevens. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Lara Elizabeth Davis. Tenzin Sherab Sherab. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Community Health, Angela Chung. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Criminology, Natalie Mary Bate. Britt Margaret Corker. Bronte Renee Devitt. Anna Taylor Gleason. Tanika Glashinsky. Nicholas Michael Sculthorpe. Catherine Wanecki. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Criminology and Forensic Science, Alexandra Nicolette Trapozanalis Giuliani. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Psychology, Marie Lynn Natalie Becker. Casey Louise Bigham. Jade Emma Brown. Michelle Linda Camodi. Scott William Dooley. Kima Durnford. Joanna Gordon. Sarah Jane Gritt. Stephanie Kendall. Ashley Kettis. James Bradley King. Charmaine Morrison. Nicholas Michael Price. Janice Ritchie. Anne Helene Sharkey. Kerry Lee Maria Strack. Rochelle Stubbing. Selena Tor. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Psychology and Forensic Science, Lana Ellen Gabrielson. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Psychology and Sports Science, Cameron Ward Douglas. For the Bachelor of Social Science, Security and Counterterrorism, Mitchell Buckley. David Michalowski. Katie Shoulders. For the Bachelor of Arts, Honours, Christina Jade Lamb. For the Bachelor of Design, Industrial Design, Honours, Alexandra Morgan Ashley. For the Bachelor of Design, Interior Architecture, Honours, Aydin Chifchiola. Isabella Luisa De Petro. Carla Grace. Julianne Nguyen. Zhe Xian Ui. Lara Elise Pilot. Lucinda Sesta. Sri Puspawati Kokrocho. Laura Jane Tuoi. For the Bachelor of Psychology with Honours, Mitchell Gregory Clowett. Monica Pham. Brendan Tan. for the Graduate Certificate in Emergency and Disaster Management, Eddie Idick. For the Graduate Certificate in Learning and Teaching Higher Education, Trevor Noel Plumridge. For the Graduate Certificate in Social Science, Male Family Violence, Peter Coburn. Paul Francis Damon. James Downey. Christine Hearn. Den Monibu Oni Kaur. Beverly Ann Louis. Lorraine Timmins. For the Graduate Certificate of Social Science, Housing Management and Policy, Susanna Eva Biast. Edward Farnsworth. Sean Kelly. Emma Marshall. Patrice Ella O'Neill. Benita Ann Ridley. For the Graduate Diploma of Multimedia, Anne-Lean Sundby. For the Graduate Diploma of Teaching, Primary, Melanie Delamont. Irene Diamant. Talia Ray Gaffney. Marina Judicere Spiteri. Tara Jane Morgan. Brooke Robertson. For the Master of Arts, Media and Communications, Carlotta Creel. Fiona Catherine Whitaker. For the Master of Arts in Writing, Vivian Margaret Chivers. For the Master of Design, Design Anthropology, Rebecca Christina Purser. For the Master of Psychology, Counseling Psychology, Gregory Aristidis Lolas. For the Master of Science, Applied Statistics, Philip Nathan Ellings. Nicole Louise Enting. Mahalakshmi Jayaraman. Andrew Ma. Kate Ann Minter. Monica Sarangal. Harvey Fu Dran. For the Master of Social Science, Couple Counselling, Laurie Walter Cato Smith. Chancellor, that concludes the awards for the Faculty of Health, Arts and Design. I now call upon Professor Bernadine van Granborg, Pro Vice Chancellor, Graduate Research and Research Training, to present the graduates from Swinburne Research.
Chancellor, graduates of higher degrees by research at Swinburne must demonstrate that their work meets the most rigorous standards. The outcome of their scholarship and research is examined by international experts to ensure that it makes a significant and original contribution to their field at international standards. Many of our doctoral graduates have presented their work at international conferences and published in international refereed journals. During their candidature, they have already been contributing to Swinburne's growing international research reputation. So as we congratulate them on receiving their award, we ask that they join the university staff on the stage. While these achievements are indeed remarkable and worthy of celebration, it's worth taking a moment to reflect on what making an original contribution to knowledge really means. To succeed in research, you need to have the courage to go into the unknown. Every thesis is a journey of risk-taking, resulting in mistakes and failures and successes in equal measure, and without which progress is simply not possible. Our graduates leave Swinburne as world experts in their chosen field, but they're armed with finely honed skills to be curious, to take risks, to disrupt convention, and to forge new paths. They also have the right expertise to make a real impact on our world. Swinburne is immensely proud that our research degree graduates will continue to make significant contributions to the advancement of knowledge, to solving the challenges confronting our world, and to enriching the communities in which they work and they live. Today, we salute the courageous and wish you well as you continue your adventure into the unknown. Chancellor, I have the honour to present to you the graduates on whom a doctorate has been conferred. For all these thesis citations, please refer to the graduation ceremony program. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Chris Malika Badra for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. Badra's thesis title is New Approaches in the Fabrication of Multidimensional Smart Materials for Biotechnological Applications. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Svetlana Borova for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. Borova's thesis title is A Data Mining Tool for Predicting Student Withdrawal. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Sarah Lorraine Curry for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. Curry's thesis title is Destination Brand Building for Emerging Nations, the Case of Timor-Leste. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. G.R. Sheher for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. Her's thesis title is Image and Video Dehazing by Regularized Optimization. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Lana Dorothy McLean for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. McLean's thesis title is An Investigation of the Relationship Between Emotional Intelligence and Specific Learning Difficulties. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Andrew John Peters for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. Peters' thesis title is Mundani Yulenge, An Examination of Aboriginal Culture, Identity and Education. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. T. Hong V. Pham for the Doctor of Philosophy. Dr. Pham's thesis title is Investigation of the Biointerfaces of Nanostructured Surfaces. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. James Daniel Collett for the Doctor of Philosophy, Clinical Psychology. Dr. Collett's thesis title is It's Not All About That BAS, Trait Bipolar Disorder, Vulnerability Weakly Correlated with Trait BAS and Not Predictive of Risky Decision Making. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Rana Abu Sina for the Doctor of Psychology, Clinical and Forensic Psychology. Dr. Abu Sina's thesis title is What's It Like on the Inside? The Impact of Self-Concept on the Educational Engagement and Delinquency of Young Offenders in a Custodial Setting. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Marie Henshaw for the Doctor of Psychology, Clinical and Forensic Psychology. Dr. Henshaw's thesis title is The Demographic, Mental Health and Offending Characteristics of Online Child Pornography Offenders, a Comparison with Contact Only and Dual Sexual Offenders. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Jim Dimitrios Kantadakis for the Doctor of Psychology, Clinical Psychology. Dr. Kantadakis's thesis title is The Psychological Mediators in the Relationship Between Disease Activity and Physiological and Psychological Distress and Quality of Life in Inflammatory Bowel Disease. Chancellor, I present to you Dr. Natasha Rogers for the Doctor of Psychology, Clinical Psychology. Dr. Rogers' thesis title is Mindful Parenting Group Intervention for Mothers with Borderline Personality Disorder Traits, Program Development and Evaluation. Chancellor, that concludes the awards for Swinburne Research. I now call upon Lara Elise Pillett, who graduated today with a Bachelor of Design Interior Architecture Honours, to speak on behalf of the graduates.
Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of the University Council, fellow graduates and guests. Today, each student in this room has reached what is at the end of a significant part of their individual journey. We are all here today to celebrate our graduation. On behalf of all the graduating students, I would like to sincerely thank everyone who supported us on our way. From the very beginning, we have felt like a part of a university community. Swinburne has a fantastic reputation, not only for its standard of teaching, but for its close, supportive environment. Staff at Swinburne especially deserve our thanks for their assistance over the years. Each student here today has been taught by people with a passion for what they do. We must also thank our classmates for accompanying us on this journey. It has been a privilege to share the classroom with people who have aiming for similar goals. But it's not just assignments and exams that make up a degree. It's also about growing as a person, something that we couldn't have done without the invaluable support of our family and friends. Through all the challenges and rewards, they have been there for us, helping us juggle our priorities and fitting in some leisure time, offering financial assistance and simply being there for us. For all of us, this is a very proud moment and something they've worked towards for a number of years. We are honoured to have you here with us today celebrating our success. Now, as we look towards starting our new journeys, we acknowledge those who have contributed to our studies. The knowledge, the friendships, and the experiences we have gained during our time at Swinburne will help us succeed in whichever path we choose to take. To my fellow students, congratulations and good luck for the future. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Lara. To Swinburne graduates, I know that today is the culmination of years of hard work, and that during this time, as Lara mentioned, you've had the encouragement and help of family and friends. On yours and the university's behalf, I wish to thank them for their support of your studies at Swinburne and for being here to see you graduate. So could I ask all the graduates to please stand, turn to face your family and friends, and join me in a round of applause to say thank you to those that have helped you reach this important milestone. Thank you. Please resume your seats. Graduates, I do hope that you will consider that your graduation is a step along the path of a lifelong association with Swinburne. Education is a continuing process, and I hope that many of you will return to Swinburne to further your studies. I would also encourage you to keep in touch with us through Swinburne alumni. At graduation, you, like I did, automatically become lifelong members of Swinburne alumni, a worldwide connected group of more than 170,000 people. This gives you access to a valuable network of professionals who share your connection to Swinburne, a powerful tool for building and developing your career and for lifelong opportunities. As well as functions in Australia, Swinburne alumni has a growing number of chapters around the world. So even if you are leaving Melbourne, you can continue your participation in Swinburne activities. Graduates, on your behalf, I also wish to take this opportunity to thank the academic and professional staff for their contribution to your education at Swinburne. Could I ask all staff to please rise? And graduates, please join me in a round of applause for the Swinburne staff. Thank you. It now gives me pleasure to call upon Professor Linda Christensen, Vice-Chancellor and President of the University, to deliver the charge to the graduates.
Before I read the charge to graduates, on behalf of the staff of Swinburne University, I would like to congratulate you on the achievements that we are honoring tonight. You graduate tonight with a deep understanding of your disciplines and an appreciation of the expectation of your chosen professions. You also graduate from Swinburne having gained distinctive graduate attributes that we believe will help you in your future careers. You have become more reflective communicators, better problem solvers, and gained proficiency in working in teams. And I trust that you have experienced and reflected upon the values that we espouse. Your education is a foundation for your future, and we look forward to hearing of your ongoing achievements. I'm sure that you will use your qualifications successfully, both in your profession that you've chosen and also in the future prosperity and well-being of your communities. One of the greatest benefits of achieving a qualification from Swinburne is the opportunity to meet and study with people from different countries and different cultures. Friendships developed can be lifelong and mutually beneficial in developing your own career and also your country's prosperity. I look forward to hearing of your ongoing engagement with us and wish you the very best for the future. May I now ask the graduates to please stand for the charge. In conferral of your award, I ask you, as graduates of Swinburne University of Technology, to strive to practice the university's values of integrity, accountability, teamwork, innovation, sustainability, and respect for diversity. I ask you to seek positive and creative ways to engage with and serve your communities, to remain curious and open to new learning and new experiences. And finally, use your knowledge, talents, skills, and passion to encourage a better future for the global community. Thank you, be seated, and go well.
This concludes the official part of this Swinburne graduation ceremony.